Good morning. We release the Czech interviews with the president of Czech Chamber of Commerce every day, and we believe that the interview in the English version should be presented to the Czech international audience, Czech-based managers mainly. So, Mr. President, what is the main message for the international management here in the Czech Republic?
Well, good morning, everybody. Indeed, we believe that we should extend our interviews also from Czech to English. First of all, I would like to thank everybody who is not Czech, but is a so-called expat, who lives and stayed here in the Czech Republic, who keeps the economic activity of his or her companies, who keep people employed, at least to the extent how much it is possible. And I would like indeed to thank you very much. And I would like also to wish you all the health and all the strength to the next, I'm afraid, rather difficult weeks. At the same time, I would like to assure you that Czech Chamber of Commerce is a partner for the Czech government, Czech parliament, and other parts of the state administration. And we tried indeed to represent the interests of all the firms and companies and even the small business people who are operating in the Czech economy. We are fighting for different measures which should be applied by the government to help all of us to overcome the difficult period with the least damages possible.
You, as a president and the whole Chamber of Commerce, formulated many requests, many requirements, how to keep the business going on and how to help the people. Would you mention just a few of them?
Yes, indeed. And I would probably separate them into two groups. The first group are people who clearly understand that there must be a massive fiscal stimulation of the Czech economy. In the different forms, and you have heard it, the postponement of payments of the taxes, the postponement or for the small business, even the abolishment of the payments of the social and health security, but also the compensation of the wages, which by law have to be paid to the people who are staying at home and still remain the employees of a company. And it is the company which by law must pay those wages. So the compensation from the state budget to the companies, the famous German name, Kurzarbeit, the German invention, which is now popular all over the world. But of course, we are fighting for many other things. We have formed a group of financial and banking experts. I can't speak about the conclusions, but we believe that we will be able to suggest to the government also the steps which will provide for a certain standstill in the banking sector, that banking sector will be much more welcoming and understanding the difficult situation of the business. But let's leave that for the next interview.
Well, the listeners might be interested in the news and everyday updates of the Czech Chamber of Commerce website, which is actually in Czech, of course, but it could help enormously to the Czech management. Would you like to mention just a few things that are visible there?
That's the second group. Then there is a lot of requests, suggestions, complaints, questions, which deal with the more detailed issues. What should I do if I would like to join those who are producing, let's say, a diagnostics machine for diagnosing of different kind of a contagious diseases, as one example. Where should I go if I want to sew the mask? That's the another, and we have tens or maybe hundreds of requests like that. I would like also to correct a little bit what you have said. We have our www.komora.cz webpage, but it is not only in Czech. There is an English version. We try, and I would like here to thank our young people here at the Chamber who translated sometimes overnight. We try to have as much as possible the Czech content also translated into English. Not all the Czech content we can translate into English, but the very basic information is there about what exactly you are asking about. That means about the interpretation of the particular decisions of the government and parliament, and at the same time, the answer to many questions from that second group of problems. I welcome everybody to have a look at our webpage.
So now we have made a couple steps. Many more steps are ahead of us. What is the main aim for the near future for the Czech Chamber of Commerce now?
Well, we try to help. We try to be the partner and constructive partner for the government. And we try to disseminate optimism, if it is possible. So maybe let's conclude this first English interview just saying, well, we will make it.